And the combination between the added sugars and the saturated fat, is that perhaps the worst combo?
That would be, that's the one study that I would like to see somebody fund. I've been trying to do nutrition research in a controlled way for a number of years. We sort of worked our way to that question. Could there be some combinatorial effect that could explain what I would call sort of the Big Mac effect by having your red meat, your bacon, and your cheese on a white bun,
right,
with your milkshake.
Right,
right. So I think that might be true, but it really hasn't been studied, and it's something I really would. It's very hard to find sponsors. These studies are hard to do. They're expensive to do. And we haven't yet found anyone interested in that question enough to seriously consider funding it, because it involves doing it. When you get into combinatorial nutrition, it gets really expensive, because you have to have an arm where there's a high saturated fat with no added, with lower carb, high saturated fat with higher carb, low saturated fat, et cetera. You get into a very big production in order to do that study properly, plus which we think there is heterogeneity in the population, that there are some people that are more sensitive to these adverse effects. So you have to have a large enough study population, 40, 80, 100 people minimum, to be able to sort out these effects. And I'm somewhat, how should I say, frustrated that that question may go unanswered.
It's a very important question.
Yeah.
We're talking about.
Right.
You mentioned that you think the role that nutrition plays in cardiovascular health is very, very important.
Right.
So I think people need to know what to eat.
Yeah. And